All right, now I know that it is crazy out there and there's a lot going on in the world and everybody's got a lot going on with their life and a lot of times it can just feel like I just don't have the time to paint. It's not important. And I get that, but understand what you're gonna get from sitting down and actually creating something with your hands. Hi, welcome to Paint Coach. I'm Chris Fornatero here to help simplify oil paint so you can get better faster. Now, a very common problem that I hear about all the time is people saying they just can't find enough time to paint. They wish they painted more. So in this video, I'm gonna give you my top 10 tips on how to get yourself to paint more. All right. Tip number one is make cleanup easier. Now, how can you do this? One example is that you can get yourself a pad of palette paper. It's very easy to clean up. I use it all the time. I use it in my demonstrations. When I'm done, I crumple it up and I throw it away. I don't have to worry about cleaning up a palette. I don't have to worry about next time I want to come to paint. Oh man, I got to clean my palette. I want to scrape it off and all the mess. Don't have to worry about that. But I know what you're thinking. You're thinking, Chris, I don't have a problem with cleaning my palette. What I have a problem with is cleaning my brushes. That's the real pain. I totally understand, and I had that problem for a very long time. That is until I saw the light. And that light came in the form of this brush dip. Yes. Geneva Arts brush dip. No, I don't get any money from this. They're not a sponsor. I have no contact with Geneva Paint or the Draw Mix Paint guy. If you've ever seen him on YouTube, that's his stuff. This stuff is incredible. All I do is I rinse my brushes in my paint thinner, wipe them off on my paper towels the best I can, dip them in the brush dip, and just set them out. And the dip is so slow drying that it will take almost over a week for it to dry and ruin the brushes. Now, granted, I paint every single day, but even still, it makes cleanup pretty much non-existent. And I'll put a link to where you can get that in the description below. All right, tip number two is use water mixable oil paints if you have to. I know for a lot of people, you're in a small apartment, oil paints got fumes, they have smells. If you have roommates, they don't like it. I get it. Water mixable oils can be a very good alternative. I was actually very surprised when I first used them how much they behaved like regular oil paints. And you don't have to get any special mediums or anything for that. You can use just water. At least that's what I do. I mean, that's how I painted this Johnny Cash right here behind me. That is all 100% water mixable oil paints using just water. And I use it pretty much like you would acrylics. I just dip the water when I want the paint to be thinner. When I don't want it to be thinner, I use less water. But if you would like me to show you how I paint something with water mixable oil paints, comment below and let me know and I'll make a video on it. So if knowing the fact that you're not gonna have to deal with paint thinner and medium and smells and fumes will get you to paint more, go try out the water mixable oils. You don't need the expensive stuff, just the Winsor & Newton brand that you find at Michael's works fine with me. All right, the next tip is don't paint things that are gonna take you forever to finish, because what's gonna happen is you're gonna have this big painting you're gonna be working on, you're gonna get a week through, you're not gonna like how it's going, you're not gonna wanna get back to it, but you're gonna feel obligated to finish it before you start something else. So anytime you wanna paint, you're gonna look over at this painting that you're not that excited about and you're not gonna wanna paint. Totally understandable. What I suggest is paint things that you're gonna get done between 1 and 3 sittings. This may mean working on a smaller surface. This may mean choosing subjects that are simple and, you know, like doing studies, maybe a little a la prima portraits, but just not getting yourself locked into a painting for a long period of time where you have the chance of losing interest in that painting is gonna help you out. Plus, you're gonna feel fresh. You're always gonna have something new to work on. You're not gonna get bored. All right, next tip is saying you don't know what to paint is not a valid excuse. Paint anything. Paint your coffee mug, paint your shoe, paint your hand, look in a mirror and paint your face, paint your friend's portrait and surprise them. Don't get so caught up in what you're painting, get caught up in how you're painting. You don't need to be inspired by something to want to paint it. Sometimes you just got to sit down and paint. And every painting you do doesn't need to be some giant majestic landscape. I've seen some people paint a soda can and it's absolutely mind-blowing. All right, my next tip is don't be afraid to invest a little money in yourself getting better. I can remember back in the day, like 8 to 10 years ago, when if you wanted to get an instructional painting video, you actually had to pay for a DVD that would be mailed to you in the mail. and that DVD at bare minimum was going to cost you at least $100. And that was just going to be watching the artist paint one painting. Now there's just endless subscription-based things. You pay $25 a month, you get all these new tutorials every month. It's absolutely crazy. After seeing how things were and the price of things in the past and what you get now and the price of them now compared to then, it's just crazy how much cheaper it's got. I mean, even I have a Patreon where you get a new tutorial every week for $9. By the way, if you want to subscribe, the link is in the description below. Find a painter that you like and get their tutorials. Most of them have like monthly subscription-based stuff. All right, since we're talking about online tutorials and stuff like that, that brings me to my next tip, which is get involved with other painters. Figure out a way to be part of a painting community. This is why I created a private Facebook group just for my patrons. And let me tell you, we love it. It is so cool seeing everybody's work. There are people in there at all different levels. Everybody's sharing, you know, advice, giving advice, asking for advice. But I mean, just seeing your peers, like other painters at your level painting, if that doesn't get your artistic juices flowing, then I don't know what does. This also goes for social media. You know, follow other painters that will inspire you to want to paint. All right, my next tip is fully understand the benefit of painting. All right, now I know that it is crazy out there and there's a lot going on in the world and everybody's got a lot going on with their life. And a lot of times it can just feel like I just don't have the time to paint. It's not important. And I get that, but understand what you're gonna get from sitting down and actually creating something with your hands. You know, sitting down, working hard, being disciplined, and having something physical to show for your hard work in your own hands. I just feel like that's a type of satisfaction that you can't get in a lot of places. And a lot of things that you do in life and you put a lot of effort in, a lot of those things you don't end up with like a physical thing to show for your hard work, and you can with painting. And I truly believe that good habits breed good habits. And if you can find the discipline to sit down and paint frequently and improve and get better and better to where you produce paintings that you're proud of, that discipline and that work ethic is going to bleed into other aspects of your life. So pretty much what I'm saying is painting will make you a better person. I mean, it's just science. All right, next tip is figure out ways to cut the cost of oil painting. I know oil paints and all the supplies, it gets really expensive. It's a lot more expensive than watercolors or acrylics. You don't need to be painting on stretched oil primed Belgian linen all the time. You know, get a canvas pad to do some studies. You don't need the really expensive oil paint that's $30 for a little tube of Cerulean blue. I highly suggest checking out Jerry's Artorama online. It's an art store that you can buy stuff online. I use it all the time. They have amazing deals. No, they're not paying me to say this. I don't have a deal with them or anything. I mean, as of making this video. All right, next tip is set yourself up a good place to paint. Now, I know not everybody has like a full studio. Trust me, I understand that just as much as anybody. For the longest time, I painted in my tiny room in my apartment. You know, my easel was pretty much touching my bed. I got oil paint all over my bed sheets. There's a period of time when I was painting on a little like 8 foot by 3 foot wide balcony out in 100 degree heat. I get it. The size of your space isn't important. What's important is that you enjoy being there. Do whatever it is that you have to do to make it a space you enjoy being in. Hang up the paintings of yours that you're proud of. Hang up pictures of paintings that inspire you. Hang up anything that inspires you. You know, put things around there that make you feel good. If you like plants and stuff, put a couple plants around if it makes you feel better. Anything to make yourself wanna be in that space. Because I mean, if it's a space you don't wanna be in and you're walking around eating macaroni and cheese, wondering like, oh, should I sit down and paint tonight? And you look over at the space and you know, I don't like that space. It's, you know, of course you're not gonna go sit down and paint. Don't let the fact that you don't actually like being in the physical space that you're painting keep you from painting. All right, and my last tip, and this is probably the most important tip, and if you've seen a lot of my videos, you've probably heard me say this before, but my last tip is honor the effort. Now that means that when you do a painting, and whether it turns out good or bad, you honor the fact that you sat down and painted something and you got better. And trust me, no matter how bad it is, you got better. Don't let a bad painting or even a series of bad paintings get you down. We all go through slumps. You got to go through the bad paintings to get to the good paintings. When you do a bad painting, just look at it and say, all right, why did this not work? You know, oh, I did this, this, and this wrong. I'm not going to make those same mistakes again. And if you keep going and you keep practicing regularly, you will get better and you're gonna be surprised at how good you can be. All right, so those are my top 10 tips. If you have some tips yourself, please share those in the comment section. Also, if you have any other questions dealing with oil painting, ask those questions in the comment section, because every Friday I do a paint talk Q&A where I answer your questions. So if you leave a question, I just may answer it on next week's paint talk. If you're looking for full painting video tutorials, I do have those, but they are on my Patreon page, which is linked in the description below. If you want to see what I paint on a daily basis, you can follow me on Instagram at Forza43. I'm Chris Fornitero here telling you to go get painting. Well, 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 look who made it to the end of the video. That must mean you really like it. May I suggest you hit that subscribe button? I would really appreciate it. Also, I highly suggest you check out this video as well. All right, I'm gonna go now.